Hey everyone, I'm back with another art making tutorial for a track that I'm not going to tell you the name of. So, while I'm making this, or when I'm finished, leave a comment thinking what you would title this piece of artwork. I'm curious. And this is actually one of the cases where I create a layer, obviously, but my background is not going to be filled off a certain colour. It's actually a linear fade, if I can find it, thank you, of the deep sea one gradient in GIMP. I think I must have edited this fade. Okay, so let's just try and get that right. If I can get this line straight. There we go. Okay, I've done it the wrong way. I always do that with these ones. This one's kind of in the right place. I think I must have just painted over this part. Yeah, okay. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna color pick this. I'm pretty sure what I did was I just painted over all of this like blue. So let's. Actually, I might have done it in that slightly lighter colour. Oh no, this is trying to find the right colour problem. That's more like it. And then what I did on the next layer. What? I hate it when my computer makes that noise. It's hilarious, but it kind of sets my nerves off. I got an airbrush. What I did was I colour picked, let's say this one on the background, and I just airbrush the line here where it changes colour to make it look a bit smoother. Just because I can, basically. And you can see in this that it's actually slightly curved, so I'm gonna put that in as well. And colour pick that, and do the same thing. Sometimes I'll do this on more than one layer, depending on how many colours I'm trying to blend. But one should be enough here. This colour here is starting to bother me slightly. I'm actually going to create another layer for this because this isn't quite smoothing how I want it to. I'll turn the opacity down, that should be fine. And put a bit on there as well, because that looks a bit weird. Might need a third layer. I should have done this the other way around to smooth out the darkest color, if I can choose the right layer. A bit more. There we go. So then I think, oh no, I didn't even do it this way. Okay, I didn't even actually do the fade like that. That's slightly embarrassing. Okay, right. I did this kind of cool symmetrical one instead. I really should have noticed that. Oh well, too late now. Right. Now this one's actually quite cool. Now there we go. Isn't that so much easier? And then what I did, as I did actually do some airbrushing, I picked this color here. Regret that layer choice, name layer later, but I did actually airbrush all of that so it was darker. Well, at least I had something right. There. Now, I think what I did to get this was I used a paintbrush. I'm choosing terrible names for these today. And I probably use a straight line tool for this. That's probably too big actually. I think I went from here down to about there. I just made a little triangly thing. Didn't think I'd had the angle quite like that. obviously down on that. Nice doing it. Cool. Yeah, maybe more like that. And I probably had an airbrush to even that out. Bigger. Not. Oh no, actually, that side is probably about right. Yeah. I think what I did was I colour picked this colour. Yeah, that looks about right. And I did a little airbrush thing here, smaller, I think, where I think I just kind of did something like that a few times, maybe fill that out a bit. I'm just going to trim that end if I pick the right tool. Because it doesn't look like that in the original. Okay, I'm going to cut that harsh and then redo it like so. And that looks reasonably similar. These look a bit different. I'm not really sure what I did. Maybe I just had a sort of that's weird. I must have had that layer below or something. Yeah, that looks right. Might have erased a very thin one in the middle actually, so you get that. Nice effect on the blend. I might blur that actually. And then